Network troubleshooting using Wireshark.
Today we're going to be talking about how to detect packet loss in Wireshark for UDP-based protocols. So for those of you who are familiar with networking, there are two major transport protocols at layer 4 of the OSI model, TCP and UDP. And what you usually learn when you're learning networking is TCP offers reliable transport while UDP offers unreliable transport. With TCP, built into the protocol is a reliable transport mechanism where any packet that is sent to a destination needs to be acknowledged by that destination. And because of that, Wireshark is able to actually show you retransmissions, meaning packets that get lost in transit and then get sent again. And therefore, it's very easy to spot when there are transmission problems between a source and destination, using a very simple filter. And that is covered in a previous video that I did last year. With UDP, the transport is unreliable, meaning if a packet between a client and a server is lost, that packet is not sent again. It is considered lost and the stream continues. And UDP is generally used for real-time applications such as voice and video. Now, because of that, it's a much more difficult with certain protocols to detect if there is packet loss with UDP. There is no easy filter to use in Wireshark that will cover all UDP applications and be able to tell you whether or not there are any problems in transmission. However, depending on the protocol, there are tips and tricks, and in some cases, actual tools within Wireshark to be able to demonstrate transmission issues and packet loss. And the one that we're going to cover today is RTP. So RTP is real-time transport protocol. It is used to carry audio and video streams between clients and is generally used in things like voice over IP, live video stream transmissions, webcams, things like that. Now, thankfully, Wireshark offers a number of ways to detect packet loss within RTP, and I'm going to show you a few of them today. So to set up the scenario, I've actually diagrammed a very common scenario that many of you may actually face in your workplaces if you are a network administrator or a network engineer. And that is a voice over IP phone at a user's desk connected to some sort of voice gateway. And usually there's a floor switch in between, and then between the floor switch and the voice gateway, there's generally a large portion of the enterprise network. In this scenario, we're going to look at a capture that contains RTP that is clean, meaning there's no packet loss. And we're also going to look at one that actually has some packet loss in it and show you how to detect that. So before we get to the packet capture, I wanted to show you some capture points which may be useful. Now, capture points are points within the network which are good to use to capture traffic, depending on the type of network gear you run and the type of servers. So in this scenario, one of the places you could capture that traffic would be the local floor switch. If you can do a span or a traffic basically mirroring from the switch, Cisco offers this, Arista, any major network vendor, that would be advantageous because then you get the traffic very close to the user. Otherwise, if you can capture it on the voice gateway or whatever destination that phone call is going to, then that would be advantageous as well. So let's move to the capture. Now, this capture is a wide open capture that is capturing many different protocols and traffic to and from a sample IP. This includes some TCP, looks like some Telnet. It includes spanning tree from Cisco. It includes SNMP. But inside of this capture, there is a RTP stream. So the very simple filter within Wireshark in order to show RTP is just RTP. And here you can see an RTP conversation between two IP addresses, 257.7.204 and 257.7.196. You'll see that the traffic is bidirectional. So you can see there's traffic from 204, and then there's some traffic from 196, and that goes back and forth. Now, as I was mentioning before, the typical filters that we use to look for TCP retransmissions, or the common markings that Wireshark does, which usually marks a retransmitted packet as black, won't exist for UDP. So we have to find other strategies to be able to detect whether or not this stream is actually healthy or not, meaning is there any packet loss. So to start, we're going to look at something called the sequence number. Now, this is very similar to the sequence number used in TCP, but with RTP, it's a little bit simpler. With RTP, each packet being sent from a given source will have a sequence number assigned, and that sequence number will increment by one for every new packet that's being sent. So you can see here, this source, which is .204, sequence number starts at one, goes to 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Now, if you want a clearer view of just that source, you can also add a filter here, and ip.source is equal to 200.57.7.204. And now we can see packets just coming from one side of the conversation, and keep an eye on the sequence numbers to look for any gaps in the sequence. So here you can see we start at number one, we go to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. So it's a little bit tedious to do this manually, but this is the basis on which the analysis can begin, because you can actually keep track of missing packets by looking at gaps in the sequence number. Now, Wireshark, as I mentioned, actually has a function built in for RTP that allows you to analyze the sequence numbers of both the forward conversation from 204 to 196, and then the reverse conversation 196 to 204 to look for loss. So to do that, what we do is click on one of the packets in the RTP stream. We go to telephony, RTP, and then click on RTP streams. Now what this brings up is a window that actually shows you the RTP streams that Wireshark has detected, along with some other information. So you can see here there are three different RTP streams. An RTP stream is considered a unidirectional conversation, meaning if I'm talking to you over a SIP call, my packet's going to you, for example, 204 or 196 going to 204 would be one conversation or one stream, and then 204 to 196 would be the other stream. Now, in this case, there's three. This stream in the middle looks like it's a little bit of nothing because there's only six packets. So it may just be, you know, the end of a conversation that is not relevant. But these two right here, the first and the last, represent a conversation. So you can take a look and see that the source port is 40376. The destination port in this case is 40376. So we can make a safe assumption that these two are related. Now, already in this screen, Wireshark is showing us some information about the quality of the stream. And specifically, it shows you here the loss percentage. So this is the percentage of packets that Wireshark has detected have been lost in this conversation. And then the way Wireshark calculates this is it does the same kind of analysis on the sequence numbers that I just showed you manually, but it does it across the entire stream. Because you think about it, this stream in this case is, you know, about 800-900 packets in one direction and about 550 packets in the other direction. You could have a stream you're analyzing of thousands, tens of thousands of packets. So detecting loss is not something you can do manually. So right away we can tell that Wireshark has said neither of these streams show any sort of packet loss, right? So if we want a little bit more detail, what we can do is actually click on one of them. So I'll click on the top one. And I'm going to do analyze. Now, this brings up more detailed analysis from Wireshark of just this one stream. So Wireshark will show you several different metrics relating to the stream. And you can see here, it's actually showing you the sequence numbers, as we went over. It correlates it to the packet number. The packet number is the number in Wireshark you'll see over here on the left, if I go back to there. It is also showing you the loss rate. It shows you things like the jitter, which is important for voice, and a number of other metrics that are important for voice calls. So this is a very convenient way of being able to analyze a voice stream to see whether or not there's any sort of loss or any other issues which would cause things like high jitter or high skew, things like that. What's more is that if you want to, you can actually go into this menu, which is Play Streams, and actually play the audio stream. Depending on the nature of the stream, and if, say, if you're in a work situation, you may not want to do that because of confidentiality reasons, but that option is available as well. So to show you what it looks like when there actually is loss detected by Wireshark, I've loaded here the same file, but underscore lossy.pcap. Now what I did was I used a script in Python to delete random packets throughout the stream. And what that's doing is actually simulating what packet loss does, which is to actually, you know, when packets are dropped in between the source and destination. So we'll do the same thing. We'll click on the packet in the stream. We'll go to telephony, RTP, RTP streams. You'll see the same three streams. The two we're interested in are the top and the bottom. But first thing you'll notice is that there's actually the number of packets as well as the percentage of packets lost reported here by Wireshark. So Wireshark has done the same analysis and detected that there's actually quite a bit of loss. If I do click on let's do the last one now. We'll do analyze. You'll see that Wireshark now actually shows you where the sequence numbers are mismatched, meaning where there's a gap. So you can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 12 is missing, etc. Right? You can see the number of packets that were expected versus the number you actually got, the percentage that were lost, and again, as well as values like jitter and the skew. Now, with voice in particular, even a very low amount of packet loss can be noticeable to users. You know, there could be packet loss that goes on throughout the entire conversation. So if I scroll down through here, you can see that there are red lines as I scroll through the whole thing. Or there could be packet loss that happens in a big burst, like say this whole filter or this whole screen is red, and then, you know, it's clean after that. Either way, it's going to be noticeable. With voice, some amount of packet loss can happen, especially if you have long distance links, you're calling a different country. But especially in business settings, the tolerance for loss is very low. So this is a very quick way of you as a network analyst or engineer being able to detect that there is loss, and then allows you to actually drill into things like, you know, how often is the loss occurring, what percentage there is, and is it, you know, bursts of loss, or is it spread out over a long period of time? That's it for this video. I hope you found this video useful. If so, please like and subscribe. Also, if you have an issue that you're working on and you would like to review the capture on the channel or get some advice, feel free to post a link to it below with the description, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Until next time.